Yo, Adam Saxon with Guy in a Cuban. In this video, I want to talk about something I ran into that was weird and threw me off. I was just doing my normal Power BI thing, and I wanted to go create a resource inside of Microsoft Fabric, and I hit a, you know what? Enough all this talking. You know we like to do it here on Guy in a Cube. Let's do what? Let's head over to my machine. So I'm here in my workspace. I'm in the Power BI view. Life is good. And I realized, you know what? I wanted to try out Microsoft Fabric, and I knew that Fabric databases were there now. So I'm like, all right, cool. I want to go check this out. I want to see what I can do here. I've got a long history with SQL, so let's go play with this. So I go for database down here. Okay, SQL database is in preview. Great, let's go create it. Wait, it says I need to upgrade to a free Microsoft Fabric trial, but what? Why? My workspace is in a capacity. I've got Fabric items turned on. What the French toast? Like what? I don't understand. This should support all of the Fabric items. You know, I started talking with people. I'm like, look, so I've got a premium capacity, not a Fabric capacity. So I was wondering, well, maybe it's only works on a Fabric capacity. But then I was told, no, it should work fine on a premium capacity. I was waiting for additional feedback. I moved on. I wanted to try this other item that's amazing inside of Microsoft Fabric called AI Skills. And this is where I can create like my own kind of agent on top of data inside of Microsoft Fabric and or, you know, just Power BI also. Stay tuned for another video. It's in the roadmap. So moving on from my database thing, and I'll go into new. We'll do AI Skills. And wait, what? Same thing. And then kudos to Anna Hoffman. She just casually mentioned it to me. I'm just assuming you enabled the preview feature. And I'm like, no, I didn't realize I had to. So let's go to the admin portal. And so if you don't have access to this, you'll have to talk to your admins to go do that. But I'm the admin in this tenant, so I can go look at this database. You'll see here SQL database preview disabled for the entire organization, and it's disabled by default. I know that a lot of customers have been asking for, hey, if it's a preview feature, please have it off by default. And so here you go. I originally hit this on the database item. Anna Hoffman helped me out. And when I hit the same problem with AI skills, I knew exactly what to go do. And so the message itself is not great in my opinion, because it's misleading. A much better error message would have been like, hey, this is a preview feature. It's not enabled. Go talk to your administrator. That would have immediately clued me into it. I have given that feedback. So let's see what happens. But anyway, so let's go ahead and turn it on. So we're going to turn on SQL databases. And if we go look at AI skills, you'll see here also disabled. Let's go enable AI skills. And then it does say 15 minutes. I found in my testing, it doesn't take 15 minutes, but it does take maybe 3 to 5 minutes for it to actually kick in through the magic of editing and the power of the internet. Whoosh. And as karma would have it, it was closer on the 15 minute side than the 3 to 5 minute that I mentioned, but whatever, it's up and running. Let's go take a look. So let's go try and make a database. We've enabled the tenant setting for the preview feature. Go database, boom, that's what you should see. Give the name of the new SQL database and then we're good. And then if we try AI skills, boom, same thing, create an AI skill. So if you know you have Fabric enabled, you know you have a capacity, you've checked the basics, and you're getting the message that you need a Fabric trial, and it doesn't make sense to you, go talk to your admin. If you're not the admin, make sure those tenant settings are enabled for the preview feature. Hopefully that helps you to get the most out of Microsoft Fabric and Power BI. All right, let me know if you have any questions down in the comments below. Would love to answer them. As always, thank you so much for watching. Keep being awesome, and we'll see you in the next video.